Hi, I'm Leslie Shimon, the lead respiratory therapist at National Jewish Health. Today you're going to learn about transtracheal oxygen. So transtracheal oxygen is an alternative to other methods of delivering oxygen to the patient. The catheter is inserted directly into the trachea. It's direct oxygen flow to your lungs. So we can bypass the nasal cannula and oxygenate more effectively with transtracheal oxygen.
My name is Mark Norquist. I have an autoimmune disease called Sjogren's syndrome. And most of the people that, when they get it, it's a dry eye, dry mouth disease, and mine happened to decide it wanted to attack the lungs. I did not like the cannula on my face. It was an irritant. It tickled. It itched. And with the glasses, it bothered across my ears. It was just very, very uncomfortable all the time. So I started looking around for ways to what alternatives there might be to using this thing. And so that's when I made the decision. I contacted Dr. Buther, asked him if it would be appropriate for me, and he said it definitely would.
Our goal is to lower their oxygen demand. That an example would be if they're on 10 liters of oxygen, we'd like to decrease that down to maybe 6 or 7. That's usually our goal.
But one of my goals is that people don't realize that there's anything wrong with me. Yes, I am limited in some ways, but I don't want somebody to look at me and think, oh, he's sick, or oh, he's diminished in any way.
Education and strong communication between our patients and your healthcare team is the key to success with transtracheal oxygen.
It gave me my life back when I was a training director and having to wear a suit and having to be in front of people and be in front of the public. It gave me my life back to where I could be a normal person.